Hey everybody, Pat here, and in this video I have a really exciting announcement to share with everybody, a big enhancement to a feature that gets used a ton in the Uptics platform. It's really pivotal. It's actually the second thing that people do in the platform before they're able to actually launch campaigns in the system. So you're probably wondering what it is. We've basically rebuilt the entire importing process inside of Uptics. We previously rebuilt the entire backend to optimize for bigger list size and stuff like that, and we're always making enhancements and changes. But in this video, I'm going to show you how to import contacts into Uptics using the new way of doing it. So it's basically a new UI process. So let's go through that. All right. So if you're on the people page, you can also do this from the settings, right? But if you import, you're going to notice a really, really big change here in the UI and the process. And I'll walk you through all the bells and whistles. So first of all, I'm going to grab a file. All right. Just give me 1 second here. Okay, so now this hasn't really changed other than the UI. So just pick one of the fields, whatever records you're importing. This is where the fun stuff starts happening. All right, so I'm going to go through a ton of the features in the importing process here now that you have access to. So I'm going to start at the top. First of all, you've got a few toggles to pay attention to. If you want to update existing contact records with new data that you might have in your file, you're going to want to toggle this on. Okay, that's not going to overwrite any existing information. Let's just say, for instance, that you changed a name or you changed a company name or you changed a lead status. It's not going to overwrite any of that. It's only going to fill in the blanks, anything that you might not have in the system already. Okay, so important to point that out. Next, if you want to assign contact records to a single owner, if you're managing records with contact owner, then you can assign them to a single owner in the system. So this helps you with a workflow. I'm going to show you one other way that you can assign owners if you have multiple contact owners, which is super, super cool. I'll show you that in just a minute here. The next option here is to upload these contacts to an existing smart list. Now it's important to point out, this is for only static lists. So you can upload these leads to an existing static list. So that'll get shown here. If you have any static lists in your system, it's going to get shown here. Otherwise you can create a new one, and it'll add all those records into that new smart list. So again, if you're using these smart lists to, you know, automatically enroll people into sequences and stuff like that, this is going to save you a step. All right. So super, super cool. All of these things are all based on user feedback that we've gotten in the platform. So really, really awesome. Now, the next thing you're going to notice here as you start mapping fields is we're auto detecting the fields. So as your column names have certain words in them, it's going to auto detect and assign. All right. So from there, basically all you need to do is you need to just click confirm. It's going to collapse it. So this is another thing that we've added just to make it a lot easier for everybody to see. You've got the little green check mark there. You know that that field's done. Same thing that will happen if you skip records, right? So if you skip records, it's going to collapse it. It's going to just make it easier to see. So all you got to pay attention to is anything, you know, expanded. If it is, then you just need to make sure it's collapsed, all right, during your process. Next, I'll show you one other thing that we've done in the create custom field. So we already had this before, but one little hack that we added here is we're going to automatically grab the name from the column header from your file and put that into the custom field to make it a little bit easier to add custom fields. So all you got to do literally is, you know, pick your options here and hit save, and it'll save it. Now, one thing I do want to point out, because a lot of people ask, if you're using a drop-down field and you have several options, you do not need to create these manually, okay? We will create those drop-down fields automatically based on what you have in your file. So all you need to do, if it's a drop-down field, select drop-down and hit save, and we'll automatically add those. You don't need to do anything else, all right? Here's actually a custom drop-down field there. All right. And the last thing I want to show you is the contact owner. So if you have multiple contact owners in your file, you can now actually map those contact owners. So what you're going to do is click that little button there. It's going to pop up with an option here where then you're going to assign the contact owners based on the values from your file, and you click save and away you go. An important thing, if you do that, it's actually going to turn off this option if you had already toggled that on, okay, because it'll overwrite, because this is mapping multiple contact owners. There's one other little thing I don't have in this file. If you have invalid information in like your email row, it's actually going to show you that you have invalid information, and you're going to have some options on whether you want to import those as blank fields or if you want to just skip the records altogether. But it's going to actually show up if you have any invalid email addresses. It'll actually show you that during the import process. All right. So those are the really big import enhancements that we've made. In addition to a lot of the things in the back end that you can't see on the front end, we've done a lot of optimizations with being able to handle larger file sizes and stuff like that. And we're always making tweaks and enhancements. So I hope you really enjoy the new functionality in the importing process. And as always, if you ever have any questions or you need anything, feel free to reach out to us. For now, happy hunting, and I hope you start winning some more customers faster. All right. Thanks, everyone. Bye.